I'm Caris Matthews and I'm here today talking with Chef Bryn Williams about our love of food and products from the coastal area in Wales. It's exciting to talk to you, Bryn, because we've both got some really potent memories of growing up in Wales and very different parts of Wales too.
Yeah, very fond memories. Going to the beach and things as you're all kids, wherever you live, going to the beach or fish and chips. That to me is fantastic.
And that smell of vinegar.
You're right, that smell of vinegar and the smell of the sea, that the combination of the both. So the great fish and chips up in Horse and Sea, which is Galleon fish and chips. We used to go there as kids. It's still there now. So if I go back home now, I'll always make a visit there. Mm-hmm. But then as I become a chef, I walk down the beach now and the foraging thing now comes into play. So you start seeing the sea beets, the samphire.
Yeah. I love samphire with
fish. Do you like it raw then, do you?
Yeah, pretty much. Or maybe I'll just warm it up with a little bit of butter.
I think that's the best way. You know, around the coastal Wales, you know, we all walk down the coastal paths. If you know where things are, samphire, sea beets, mussels.
Sorrel.
They're there. Oysters as well. Scallops around everywhere. They're little secrets around the coast. They're little gems dotted all around from north down to south. It's some fantastic places if you know where they are.
Give us some tips of where they can head immediately.
Commie mussels, one of the oldest supplies of mussels in Britain. Seawater and fresh water goes through the estuary, and that's why the shells are really, really strong and loads of flavour. Going away from North Wales down to Aberaeron Harbourmaster. They're so committed to local source ingredients and staff. They speak Welsh and English, and they know the land, they know the supply, they know the farmer, they know the fishermen. And for me, if you want a taste of Wales, that's where you head, Harbourmaster. I'll confess, I've only dived twice in Britain. One for scallops in North Wales and Pwllheli, and we cooked them within 25 minutes, half an hour of catching them. And then I dived for spider crabs in Pembrokeshire. It was so clear, a good 10 metres, and the amount of spider crabs we caught was fantastic.
Okay, tell us in detail. So was it Saundersfoot there?
It was just off Saundersfoot. It's just about 3 miles away from Saundersfoot. So we caught these scallops. I took the scallops out the shells, put the shells back onto the barbecue. It's a little bit of butter, a little bit of olive oil, garlic, cut the scallop in half, put that into the butter, put the lid back on, 2 or 3 minutes they were cooked. They were the nicest scallops I've ever tasted in my life. And I don't think I'll ever eat scallops that fresh ever again. 20 minutes from catching to eating. Beautiful. We buy our salt marsh lamb from Pwllheli, which is right on the coast up in like west, northwest Wales. The tide must go over the field twice a day to be classed as salt marsh lamb. It can't just be by the sea. So the water's got to, the sea's got to go over the land. Yeah. It's just different. Yeah. The reason that is because of the salt content that they eat from the grass, the sea beet, the samphire. It just turns the fat a different colour, but it's a very subtle, salty flavour to it. A friend of mine just opened an amazing restaurant called Coast.
Perfect name.
And it's on the coast, exactly. And it's literally the fresh fish they get from there. So this is a chef called Will Holland, and he cooks fish. Very, simple cooking, amazing flavours, and he serves it to locals and tourists alike.
And this is another thing you can do when you visit Wales. Ask the locals, where's a good place to fish for mackerel when it's mackerel season? Yeah. Get a line, a real basic rod and line.
Dangle
it. Be safe. Stay safe. Don't fall off the rock.
Yeah.
But fish directly into the sea.
I've fished in Saundersfoot as well, and mackerel. I caught hundreds of mackerel in 2 days. Sea bass as well. We used to go cycling around Anglesey when we were kids. We always camp in Benllech. So we should either try and catch our own mackerel off the rocks again. If we didn't, we'd buy from a local fishermen and we'd cook them on a barbecue as well. What's great about Wales is our suppliers. The raw ingredients are coming from Wales, down the Welsh coast. There's some fantastic suppliers there. So the fishermen go out, they catch their stock, the local restaurant buys it, feeds the local people or tourists, so the money goes back into the local area.
And if the food's good in an area, people are going to come back.
People come back, definitely. And I think Saundersfoot around that coast is so beautiful. Do you know, I did the Newport Food Festival 3 or 4 years ago, and after I did my demo using local fish that was caught in Newport, I got given a bottle of beer, and I thought, what's this? It was one of the nicest beers I've ever had. Tiny Rebel.
Tiny, what a
Tiny
great
Rebel.
Name.
And it's, you want to see the labels. The labels are very wacky. Once you see a Tiny Rebel label, you will never forget it. Fantastic with food.
I'd like to come and visit your home area in North Wales.
Okay.
Where would you take me? For a coastal pub experience.
Tu Coch.
Yeah, it's just, Red House.
Yeah, Red House. It's on the beach, so you go all the way down to Nevin, so northwest, down the Yard, down the Llyn Peninsula. And you know what? You should know this. They're one of the best places for a sing-song. One of the best pubs ever. It just goes to show the fun and the experience you can have along the Welsh coast. On a day out, walking a dog. You might walk the dog and pick some free lunch. You know, if you're camping or in a caravan. We've just got some beautiful scenic routes, amazing pubs, amazing ingredients. You put them together, give it a little bit of a shake, you've got the best day out ever. And that's what Wales can offer.
It's been really good to talk to you today.
Diolch, Caris.